Honourable members, I want to welcome you to this afternoon's sitting. Yesterday, during the deliberation that we had on brutality on members or women members of parliament, the discussion was centered on the need to preserve the delicate political space of the women. As women, we must guard our space jealously. We must guard it. You are elected, and as a result of that, I want to issue directives. I issued directives and I want to retaliate. The commemoration of the international recognized days, such as Women's Days, must be respected by all the stakeholders. And where a woman wants to celebrate, a woman member of parliament, it should be respected and she should be allowed to do it without any interference. Members of parliament and citizens out there can always arrange to commemorate such days lawfully. The Minister of Internal Affairs should investigate all the security personnel who were involved in the interruption of the celebration of Women's Days for the women members of parliament who have already reported it to parliament. The Sectoral Committee on Presidential Affairs should inquire on the role of the resident state attorneys in disrupting the members' constituency activities. Resident district commissioners, the RDCs, should interest itself on the role of the RDCs and also give this house the terms of reference of the RDCs as they are in those areas. Whether brutality is one of them, the Prime Minister should table in Parliament the schedule of disbursement of funds, the 3 million shillings that is meant to be sent to each district for celebration of the Women's Day. As said yesterday, the Right Honourable Prime Minister should also table an action that has been taken on the parties that have been mentioned as per the directives, the RDCs, the police officers, and those persons that are involved. And then the Minister of Presidential Affairs should appear before Presidential Affairs Committee to give an explanation to whatever happened on her RDCs and report back to this house within 1 month. Honourable members, on 14th March 2023, the Public Service Pension Fund Bill was read for the first time in this house, and it was